أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأنصاره وأزواجه وأتباعه وزيد أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters, I'm gonna talk today about one of the great Sahaba. May Allah be pleased with them. And this related to something going on these days. The Sahabi name is Abu Dujana radiallahu anhu arda. The Arab used to say لكل امرئ نصيب من اسم. Like if your name is a lion, this little part of your personality like a lion. If you are a pig, like this. If you are a dog, like that. And this is the some studies came out, Journal of Personality and Social Psychology agreed with this. And what make me amazed Abu Dujana character, and some people call him themselves Abu Dujana these days, is deception is misused, like Sharmusa when you say I'm Salafi. Who's Abu Dujana radiallahu anhu arda? Sammak ibn Kharsha from Bani Sa'ida, from Ansar al-Khazraji. He witnessed Badr and Uhud and Mashahid and Hunayn, and Allah chose him in Al-Yamama. Look at the character of the Sahaba, of the real Arabs, not the transformer. The Prophet ﷺ had a sword and he said, who take this sword? And he paid the due. Who take this sword? All the Sahaba love to take. Me. And no, he didn't give it to anybody. Even Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu arda was in that day and he didn't give it to him. And this refutes some of the son of Muta allegation. Abu Dujana knew what the Prophet ﷺ mean. And said, I take it and I pay the due. What is the due? What is the tax for that? And he said, you take it and you go forth until you get victory or Allah choose you. Abu Dujana, not a keyboarder like these people these days. He used to have a red headband. And when he put it on, it means he's serious. And he put it on and walk and take the sword and walk in a pride way. Not pride, this is pride, no, different. And the Prophet said, Inna Allah yakra, Allah hate this way of walk, except in this situation. So another lesson from here, you are not allowed to be proud, to have kibr, not proud. You don't have to be kibr. Like this khanzir when he still studying and he said, where is the scholar? This is very big operation to the real scholar. And the Prophet ﷺ praised him in the battle of Uhud. You know what happened? And he said, if you see me in the battle of Uhud, no creation around me except Jibreel alayhi salam in his right hand side and Talha ibn Ubaidullah, one of the 10 people promised Jannah, guaranteed Jannah. And he mentioned, and the sword of Abu Dujana ghayr damim. Abu Dujana, look at the Muslim when in Al-Yamama, when the apostasy war, Abu Dujana bin, he asked him to throw him over the castle. And he did, they did. The Muslim cannot open the door And this is refute Sheikh Dunki when he misinterpret the verse وأنفقوا مما وأنفقوا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وأنفقوا في سبيل الله ولا تلقوا بأيديكم إلى التعلق. It means like this: don't spend in the way of Allah and do not destroy yourself. Sheikh Dunki interpreted something different to suit his status, because the man doesn't have visa and he wants to be so much bent down, and he told him, oh, don't do these things. But in the Sahabi asked people to throw him over the castle, and he went inside and opened the door for them. I have a personal experience with the name Abu Dujana, the Egyptian in Afghanistan. May Allah accept him. He was memorizing Quran and the Bukhari and Muslim. And he was 6 foot tall. And may Allah accept him. Allah chose him in Salang, Panjshir Valley. And that day they took down 504 Russians. This is Abu Dujana, and I want your brother to read, please. Move forward. And it's not, brother, it's not, if you tell me my father memorizing Quran, Sheikh Donkey mother memorizing Quran. Muhammad al-Isa, and this, all this Khamazir and Sidis, and this memorizing Quran. Allah never tell you memorize Quran. If you memorize it, it's a bonus to you and your parents. But if you memorize it and you read like a donkey, this memorization gonna be cursed on you. Assalamu alaikum. It's Asr time. May Allah bless you. And don't forget, the majority of the hypocrites in my nation are the reciter and memorizer. Because they twist it, like Sheikh Dunki memorize this, like Ali Dara, turn around this to get 100,000. So, now, any donkey listen to him, he will believe, oh, if I give 10,000, I give £10, 100,000, I have 1 million good deeds.